sun, the sun, behold the sun, great God, sun still riseth in our rubaiyat, and strikes the towers with a shaft of light. The sun still rules everything, even the sky as we know it, even love as we know it.
And the sun, the sun, the sun, my visible father, making my body visible through my own eyes.
My case to come up. And I'm waiting for Voznesensky to turn on with us and speak love tonight. And I'm waiting for Aphrodite to grow live arms at a final disarmament conference. And I'm waiting for our iron comrades to attend in a new rebirth of wonder. And I'm waiting for Voznesensky to answer. And I'm waiting for Neruda to answer. And I am perpetually waiting a rebirth of wonder. Why are you so puritanical, comrade, kicking Allen Ginsberg out of Czechoslovakia? Americans love travel. We love exotic places and people. We dig Chinese chicks, we dig Cuban chicks, we dig Arab boys. You'll think ours are exotic too. And blessed be the fruit of transpopulation with no more nations. Hosanna, Pulchrissima, Kyrie, Hallelujah. We'll all still have the sun in which to recognize ourselves at last across the world, over the obscene boundaries.
Why I fight it, fight for that, for you, and her, and he. Fight for all humanity. Not in fascinated fear, as moths fight the light, as though the atom were the monster, when it's we who have the power to see or cloud the universe, a new flower. If we keep it on a human scale, combat the darkness loud, drown the doom-boom flight of bomber's night, unmourned mortality of a mushroom shroud.
Mutation of the spirit. What make of day? Quickly into tunnels I run, huddling there, a tremble, eyes darting how and where. Last night, a white apple fell from the loneliest tree in the world. Today, the field is green, the sun bright and warm. Children attend their spirits, the old knit. Chicken cries, sacramental sobs from the chapel, a window closes, loneliness, grandeur and blue lambs, world eyes, rinsed light, swimming deer, and now the long hike back to the city, smells of rats and pasty poisons, horizons of fuming domes, dynamos, vast sixth sense, smudge pots, gasping black smoke, cheesecloth faces, dead carts, bells, a white arm, a long pale arm falls across the port. Days and days of snow, starched air, nurses, children, navies. I would communion go. Oh, come nights of fire. I can't face the stiff, blanched day. Ah, dark, bad fire. Ah, still the day. Blackened, useless destruction. All remains. I shan't go out. Sit in my room in my gloom and laugh out my night. Dawn, I smiled at the rooster and walked into the day. Sun, sun, sun. Knelt and heavened a child again, praying to an ignored flower, sun and green, cows and brook. Black is fat, is thick, is deep, is brink, death and sleep. And white is thin, is a losing man, a slouched old woman. The field is green, the sun is bright. Old men with wide pants hold twisted belts, and children attend their spirits. The vision was peace. Oh, how silly I was in that scene. Easter sirens and lights and loud numbers, unborn ages, wriggling shapes and cowls. Yesterday has become a century away, meager valor of historic years away. Who rings this piteous surrender of the spirit like a wet towel? Don't say. That's it.
It was my spiderhood, a whole new mythology, a cavern full of wicked sisters, a whole new breed of them mutated by this new hallucinogenic vitamin which I hereby christen Spiritlect, the vitamin which has made the intellect get up and walk. A couple of hefty spider sisters brush past, lugging another dead academician.
Love! Come, man, come!
You want to come up?
Come!
I'll read the poem. Yeah,
I'll let you finish.
Yeah, I'm gonna finish.
Take it easy, don't.
Read the text. Read the text.
Yeah, okay. The text.
Read the text. Read it, Simon Vicanu.
Yeah, that was... Hey, you're a lovable idiot, you know, really.
Is it as serious to me as it is to you?
No, I mean, the reading of his poem has already been fucked up, so, you know, I...
Read it, Mark!
Well, read it! Okay, right, you know... Who's... No. So... Now we're all in here at last together. And even you, the darker sister of them all, though I know this backstairs knowledge, and of course we're all specialists in something, and yet how far back can this guild keep going into that tunnel which is your bravery, Alan, and which all our voices echo suddenly, sinisterly. Oh, happy light bulb, still so patiently preaching your doctrines, indoctrinating your systems. Light bulbania, why couldn't I realize this is where I always really lived? I'm sorry, Alex.
Well, you're not reading anymore.
I'm reading the last poem.
No.
I don't care. I've got one short poem, which is why did you hate me?
My God!
Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen, hold on. This evening is an experiment, and we're finding out about just what happens when we put 5,000 people in a hall with a few poets trying to be natural. Now, hold on. Harry Thainlight wants to read one more poem, one very short one. And I think that he should be allowed to do so.
No. This poem is just essential to this reading. It's called Lark Song. I'm sorry. It's called Lark Song. It's about the lark. No, it's about the lark. Right. Right. Fresh wildernesses. Resurrected from the raw broken concrete at the airfield's edge, where mounting from the coursing grasses, a lark's fistful of blood and feathers flings its song into the teeth of the wind and drops back broken. Oh, bursting minstrel heart pounding amidst those thrashing grasses, yet but once more rise, climb, oh, shine out emblematically against that ceaseless silver, soaring and settling, yea, even to where the giant rocket ship is standing, balanced upon its own exhaust blast, terrible, oh, sing, ecstatic, unshaken by that heart-shaking, cathartic roar. That's the lark. That's...
I've got to say something just about that poem. I'm sorry.
Yeah. No.
Okay, crazy, and planet later.
Let's say something about that poem.
You did a great thing. Harry doesn't feel he's done himself justice. He wants to explain a little something about the poem, but I explained to him that it's a damn fine poem, and we really don't need to know any more about it. Not at the moment, anyway.
Whom it may concern. I was run over by the truth one day. Ever since the accident, I've walked this way. So stick my legs in plaster. Tell me lies about Vietnam. Heard the alarm clock screaming with pain. Couldn't find myself, so I went back to sleep again. So fill my ears with silver. Stick my legs in plaster. Tell me lies about Vietnam. Every time I shut my eyes, all I see is flames. made a marble phone book, carved all the names. So coat my eyes with butter, fill my ears with silver, stick my legs in plaster, tell me lies about Vietnam. I smell something burning, hope it's just my brains. They're only dropping peppermints and daisy chains. So stuff my nose with garlic, coat my eyes with butter, fill my ears with silver, stick my legs in plaster, tell me lies about Vietnam. Where were you at the time of the crime? Down by the cenotaph, drinking slime. So chain my tongue with whiskey, stuff my nose with garlic, coat my eyes with butter, fill my ears with silver, stick my legs in plaster, tell me lies about Vietnam. You put your bombers in, you put your conscience out, you take the human being and you twist it all about. So scrub my skin with women, chain my tongue with whiskey, stuff my nose with garlic, fill my ears with silver, stick my legs in plaster, tell me lies about Vietnam. Love poem entitled Stunted Sonnet. Love is like a cigarette. The bigger the drag, the more you get.
So, in the evening, man sits by the fire he has tamed, on the ground he makes fertile. Outside, his creature, the horse, that ran wild before he came. Oh, clever man. And men have grown inside themselves minds that move further and faster than light or the changing air, and speech men invented to trap the mind as it flew, and so to hand things down. And above all, we have learned the intricate civilities of government, how to avoid unhealthy places, and how to escape from the wind and the rain into cities of slate and ivory. But even as we make, no matter how much we make, and whatever we make, we long to destroy the thing we have made. Finding no enemies, we become our own enemy. As we trap the horse, so we trap other men. But the others strike back, trap closing on trap. Having eaten enough, man must next build a wall around whatever food is left, and other men must pull down that wall. So the roof gets split, and the rain and the changing air wash away whatever is left of man and his cities when man has done with them.
When I write, I have trouble with my tenses. Where I was tomorrow is where I am today, where I would be yesterday. I have a horror of committing fraud. It is all very difficult, the past even more than the future, for the latter is at least probable, calculable, while the former is beyond the range of experiment. As the ghosts rise upwards over the grave wall, I re-coffin them neatly and bury them. It is, I suppose, my last will and testament, although insofar as I have a choice in the matter, I shall not be dying for a long time. One can only cultivate oneself as one awaits the issue. If eternity were available beyond death, if I could be as certain of it at this moment as I am sure of the fix I have only to move my hand to obtain, I should in effect have achieved it already, for I should be already beyond the pitiless onslaught of time, beyond the constant disintegration of the present, beyond all the problematic struts and viaducts with which prudence seeks to bridge the chasm of anxiety, with the ability to say, avoiding unseemly haste, I'll die tomorrow without bothering to intend it or not to intend it, as bravely as the fabled gladiators of ancient Rome.
Schon schön flank war das Wort, schon das Wort war bleib flott, schon flott war das Wort, schon das Wort ist Fleisch geblorden, schon schat schon das Schums geblomt. Schon schön schlank schar das Wort, schon schat Wort schar Fleisch schlott, schon flott war das Wort, schon schat Wort ist Fleisch geschlorden, schon schat schon das Schlums geschlomt. Schlutz, Flotz. Grrt, grrt, grrt. Zinkrum, zinkrum. Leppen, Leppen, EO, 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 puh, puh. Na, 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 Polion, 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 na, Polion, Polion, na, Polion, Polion, na, Polion, 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 na, 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 Polion. The last, to end up with, a poem by one of the fathers of sound poetry, Kurt Schwitters, Fury of Sneezing. Wozniosensky's are groaning yet voiceless. My cries have been torn onto miles of magnetic tape, an endless red tongue snaked round a big spool. I have been taken apart, dismantled, and dragged to interrogations. No, I've been back for months and all alive. No, I've been home for months, but not all of me. Somewhere beyond the seas, the spies in their spinach tint suits are watching the movies unwind with owlish x-ray stares there on the screen. Blue light on the couch, you sit smiling at me and stretching your arms, and he couldn't make it. One of them grunting, one of them groaning out, what a chick. The hunchback stares somber through one purple eye. Does it hurt, Mr. Wozniacki? Let go, you creep, let go, Quasimodo. My soul is burning and bleeding in the glare of liberty's cleaved lights, the tender, wet stares of their bloodhounds. Andre, would you like to read? Oh, now I have to re-navigate all this bad poetry. The change. I will now read poems which you have not seen published. I have to read slowly that he will understand. It will come out of the mouth of the pilot, the dry-lipped diplomat, the hairy teacher, will come out of me again, shitting the meat out of my ears on my cancer deathbed. Oh, crying man, crying woman, crying gorilla shopkeeper, crying dysentery bone face on the urinal street of the self. Oh, Negro beaten in the eye in my home. Oh, black magicians in white skin robes, boiling the stomachs of your children that you do not die, but shudder in your serpent and worm shape forever. Hail to your horrible desire for godly pride. My heaven's gate will not be closed until we enter all human shapes, all trembling donkeys and apes, all lovers turned to ghosts, all acres on trains and taxicab bodies sped away from date with desire, old movies, all which was refused, all which was rejected, the leper sexed hungry of Nazi conventions, hollow-cheeked Arab Marxists of Akko, crusaders dying of starvation in the Holy Land. Oh, thin Bengali sadhus, adoring Kali mother, hung with nightmare skulls. Oh, myself under your pounding feet. Yes, I am that worm soul under the heel of the demons. I am that man trembling to die in vomit and trance in bamboo eternities, belly ripped open by red hands of courteous Chinaman kids. Come sweetly now back to myself as I was. Kabir says this, I am a mass of sores and worms. I am false name, the prey of Yamantaka, devourer of strange dreams, the prey of radiation and the prey of police, hells of the law. I am that I am. I am the man and the atom of hair in my loins. This is my spirit and physical shape. I inhabit this universe. Oh, weeping what is against my own nature for now. Come, sweet, lonely spirit, back to your body. Come, great God, back to your only image. Come to your many eyes and breaths. come through thought and motion, up all your arms, the great gesture of peace and acceptance. Abhaya mudra, mudra of fearlessness, mudra of elephant calmed and war fear ended forever. The war on man, the war on woman, the ghost assembled armies vanish in their realms. In Russia, the young poets rise to kiss the soul of the revolution. In Vietnam, the body is burned to show the truth of only the body. In Kremlin and White House, the schemers draw back weeping from their schemes. In my train seat, I renounce my power so that I do live. I will die. And over for now the vomit, invisible skull, the fear of bones, the grasp against man and woman and babe. From this single birth reborn that I am to be so, my own identity now nameless, neither man, nor poet, nor dragon, nor god, but the dreaming me under physical stars with tender red moons in my belly, and the sun, my visible father, making my body visible through my own eyes. Alex, give me a limit. Alex, Toki, does anybody have the time? It's a 11:15. No. Oh, well then I'll read one poem. I'll read one poem left, if I can find my book. No, I have a big, long, I have my book. I've lost my poetry book.